What is up, guys? Alex here. Bringing you my first ever Funko Pop collection video. Hopefully, the first of many. I was gonna try to do this in order by the way that I got them, but then I kept thinking like, nah, it's gonna be way too complicated. Plus, some of them I kind of forgot the order in which I got them. So, yeah, it's just gonna be randomly. I've laid all the pops close to me. So yeah, let's get started because I'm pretty sure this is gonna be a long video. Well, maybe not. Maybe like 20 minutes at the most. But anyway, yeah. First thing to get started, we got the Smuggler's Bounty, Ben Kenobi exclusive. Yeah, sorry guys, I had to get away for a second there. Yeah. He was part of one of two Funko Pops. Here's the other pop you could have gone with the Smuggler's Bounty. I think it was the Cantina edition, yeah. With the blue Snaggletooth. Apparently this one was the rarest to find. Or not the rarest, but the most highly valued pop. Some of them I will be taking out of the box and posting pictures on the side. Others I'll just leave mint in the box. These I haven't opened yet. So yeah. These next two are the PX exclusive New 52 Batman and Wonder Woman. So yeah, let's get a closer. Let's see, there we go. And I think this is the first set, because I know there's also Deathstroke and Flash, and I want to say Green Lantern. Yeah, Green Lantern. Wonder Woman, her design is pretty much the same in every pop. The only difference is the colors. Yeah. Next, we got the Game of Thrones Hastings. Well, I think it was Hastings exclusive. I'm not really sure. If I remember correctly, it was limited to 3,000 or 3,500. Versions of these, or not versions, a set, whatever, you know what I mean. But yeah, it's the Game of Thrones, Daenerys, I'm guessing. I'm sorry if I butchered that name. I haven't started watching Game of Thrones. I know I should have. Yeah. You can see limited edition. And if it shows, it... Yeah, you can see the tape right here. Has not been opened. And she is metallic, but just the dress. Dragoon. Again, I don't know. I think he's just like a regular pop vinyl. Yeah. Next up, we got the Iron Throne. This one I have actually opened a couple times, if you follow me on Instagram. It's a really good pop to have if you want to like model your pops, put them on the throne and shit. Then we have the PX exclusive Flocked. Swamp Thing. The weird thing about him is you get the DC lineup of the first, well, I don't think it's the first series. Yeah. You get Batman, Robin, Batgirl, Joker, Superman, and Wonder Woman. So I don't know what's up with that. That's just kind of been weird for me. If y'all know, post your comments down below. Next, we got the Hot Topic exclusive Falcon. He's actually a pretty cool pop. The design on him is very, very awesome. I have not yet opened him, I think. Have I? No, doesn't look like it. Yeah. Here's all the pops you can get from that series, except for the exclusive ones. This next one I actually got at the Hot Topic in San Antonio. It's the Marvel Loki. I don't think he's the same from the movie, even though they use the same mold. So yeah, as you can see, you get Loki, Odin, which I actually almost got, but I decided to go with Loki. Heimdall and Lady Sif, or Sif, I think it's Sif. Sif, yeah. Hold on. There we go. One more time. Next up, we got a movie pop. It is Scarface. I've seen most of the movie. I'm still watching it, even though I've bought the movie like a couple months ago. I know. It is good. For me, it's good. I feel like it could be better. I'm gonna get so much hate from that, saying that. Oh my god. Next, we got another Smuggler's Bounty exclusive. This one was the Resistance, I think that's what they call it. It is the Flock Chewbacca. So yeah, that's super cool. There is another version of a Flock Chewbacca, but that was, I think, a 2012 San Diego Comic-Con exclusive. I know it was a Comic-Con exclusive, but I can't remember which one. Sorry if I'm going a little fast on some of these. Next up, we got, I think this is from, yeah, this is from the original Disney line. It's the Boogeyman from Nightmare Before Elm Street. Back here you can see, I think this is series 2. Because I think series 1 has like the Mr. Incredible, Woody, Buzz, and all that. Let's see. Yeah. Once again. Alright. Up next we got Hot Topic exclusive, Glow in the Dark Storm. Well, I think she's Glow in the Dark, can't remember. So many different pop variants, you know. But yeah. Here's the original lineup. I'm really hoping to get a, hold on. Yeah, Professor X. I saw two of them a couple days ago at Hastings, but I didn't pick them up. Didn't have the money, so I was like, I'll wait. Sure enough, someone scooped them up. Yeah, I have taken this one out of the box, actually. Her paint job is actually a little messed up on her cape. But other than that, from what I'm seeing right now, it looks pretty decent all around. It's just a couple of smudges. I think it was in the back of the cape. This next one, I have to give a shout out to Digital Reality. Oh, fuck, I'm sorry if I fucked your name up. From the guys at Digital Reality, the Loot Crate exclusive, Batman, Joker, Batman. Again, this one I've never taken out of the box and I would never do. Yeah, or will, sorry, past tense. The art on him is super awesome. There's a little smudging on his yellow bat symbol, but other than that, from what I can tell, he's in pretty good condition. I'm next. Is the regular roller derby Harley Quinn. I say regular because there was a Hot Topic pre-release of her a couple months ago. I think it was like back in October of 2015. Yeah, there's, I think that's a comic. Either that or it's just a poster, but I'm pretty sure it's a cover art from a comic. Stupid glare. Anyone of those white things. Next up, I actually saw this guy sitting on the shelf for like months on end. No one would buy him for some reason. And that is the Elvis Hot Topic exclusive Stitch. I'm a huge Stitch, Lilo and Stitch fan. Love that movie. Yeah, you get Lilo, the Stitch 626, Scrump, and Elvis Stitch. Once again. Yeah. Up next, we got the Hot Top exclusive Black Lantern Reverse Flash. I'm really hoping they come back out with the Black Lantern regular Flash. I heard a lot of gripes about him having like real shitty paint job. Luckily, mine, from what I can tell, has nope, never mind. Just like a little scrape on his shoulder. And I think, yeah, I can see why. Still a good, great pop though. Yeah, you can see the scrape on his shoulder I was talking about. Real cool. And the Black Lantern, Batman. I wish they would come out with Black Lanterns of Wonder Woman, Superman, since they did the White Lanterns with them too. Just me. Maybe it's just me. Maybe you feel that way too. Up next is Carnage. Love this dude. Back from the, I want to say 93 or 94 cartoon, I'm not sure, but I know it was in the 90s, from The Amazing Spider-Man. This dude was fucking psycho. A fucking glare. Yeah. See, Anti-Venom and Venom. Although Venom you can only get at Walgreens, and the Walgreens we have, before we have, just they have hardly carry any pops, and the ones they do carry are always fucked up and shit, like most Walgreens are. Yeah. Next, we got the one I've just gotten recently. I did a video about him last time. It's the 6-inch Giant Man. There we go. Can't wait for the movie. I've heard so many good things about it. I saw on Instagram a couple days ago, got 100% on Rotten Tomatoes. I'm like, hell yeah, I'm gonna watch that shit. I am gonna drop a review on that shit. I might watch it like 3 times. I watched Star Wars twice. I tried to see Deadpool twice, only saw it once, but yeah. Up next is my most highly valued pop, and that is, I still can't believe I got so lucky with this pop, the Metallic Chase exclusive Superman. This guy goes up for like $100 now on Amazon. It might be cheaper on eBay, I don't know, I don't check eBay that much, but yeah, I got so lucky. I thought he was going to be worth like $15-$20 because it's an exclusive, but no. $10, just like any old pop. Yeah. I really need pop protectors for some of these guys, because damn. First series lineup, I think. Series 1, Series 2. With the retired Riddler and retired Penguin. I wonder why they don't have Two-Face on there. Come on. Up next. Unmasked Vader. That's it. Bossk. Emperor Palpatine. I don't know who... Hammerhead. Someone explain Hammerhead to me. Was he a bounty hunter? Or what? I never remember seeing him in any of the movies. Maybe he was a Batman character or something. I don't know. But fuck. So much glare. Up next is the GameStop exclusive Black Widow from Age of Ultron with Captain America's shield. Again, shout out to Digital Reality. They actually helped me get this pump. The dude actually called me up and like, hey, there's a Black Widow with Captain America's shield. Get over here quick. Because he works over there, so sometimes he'll hook me up. No discount or anything, but you know. This next one is the new TIE Fighter pilot from The Force Awakens. It was a Smuggler's Bounty exclusive, the first one. I think it was the first order box. It's alright. It looks pretty much the same as the other ones, but the variant that most people wanted was this one with the red lines going across them. I was happy with this one until I opened it and saw he had like a huge like glob of dry glue or something on his foot. I'll put a picture in the video and show you guys later. But yeah, that seriously bummed me. I'm like, what the fuck? But then again, no, it was their first like order box thing. And like from what I've heard from other collectors is like, especially from the Marvel Corps, when they first started doing it, some of the pops were kind of messed up with the paint and shit. So I can see why, but that's still disappointing. Then we get the Chrome Captain Phasma. She is shiny as fuck. There's no way I'm not gonna get a glare or not get this in without a glare showing. Oh, wait, that's pretty good. Shiny. Same as the TIE Fighter. Damn, going on 17 minutes now, shit. Then we got the X-Force Hot Topic exclusive Wolverine. Oh, it's really helping to find the Deadpool one. These old school ones that they're like reissuing or relaunching or whatever don't really have too good of a paint job. Or maybe that's just because they're so old. Two hearts to find from this series are these two guys. I've seen like a bunch of Hulks over at Hastings every now and then. Next is the Hot Top exclusive Chrome Vader. This guy I snatched up immediately when it came out. Like on the day, I think. He is super, super awesome. A little weight to him too. Yeah. Original Chewbacca. Greedo, Stormtrooper, Leia, Han, Vader of course, and Yoda. I heard the hardest one to find is Lando. He goes for like, I think, 80 to 100 bucks. I'm not sure, I can't remember. Excuse me. Might be wrong on that 80 bucks too, so don't quote me on that. Next is the Invisible Blood Splattered Predator. This guy's super awesome. There is an blood splattered invisible one. I don't know where to find him. I think you can just search online. But he does go for a pretty good price. I will eventually get the Xenomorph pop. I just don't know when. It looks kind of eh to me. Whether or not I will get the regular Predator, probably yeah, because he actually does look pretty cool. Next, we got the Hot Topic exclusive Dancing Baby Christmas Edition Groot. Damn, that was a mouthful. Yeah. I think the only difference between him and the regular ones, because I've seen like a bunch of other Christmas Baby Groots and like GameStop and other shops, is that he has like glitter, snow, like you can see, or snow glitter or whatever on him. Because on the side he doesn't have any snow on him, so I'm guessing that's why he's a Hot Topic exclusive. Really nice now. Yeah, really nice though. Shit. Up next is the regular Obi-Wan Kenobi. Try to think of a quote, come thinking of it in time. Overall, his paint job's kind of good. They messed up kind of on his beard. Like, it leaks over to the mouth, and the face kind of leaks over to the beard. But other than that, it's pretty good. Next, one of my favorites, the Hot Topic exclusive Anti-Venom. Don't know much about him. Supposedly, he was created, or... Fuck, I'm not even gonna go into it because if some comic book nerds watch this, they're gonna get super pissed at me. All I know is that he kind of like destroys or cures people of the other symbiotes. Whether or not he kills the person after he destroys the symbiote, I don't know, but something along that line. Sorry, don't say caught up with the comics, just movies. Yeah, once again, Carnage and Venom. And next we got one of the cutest fucking pops you'll ever see. It is the Flock Stitch Hot Topic. Been talking too much, shit. It is the Hot Topic exclusive Flock Stitch. There is another version of him where he's like actually happy. This one's like depressed as fuck. Like honestly, looking at it right now, gonna be sad. Yeah. Don't know why they would make me look so sad. Seriously, look at that face. Look at that face. Ugh. Up next, we got the 2015 Comic-Con exclusive Twisty with no mask. This one was actually my first Comic-Con pop, I think. Either that or was the Game of Thrones one. Or did I get them at the same time? Oh, well. Yeah. Funny thing is, I actually heard he goes less for the regular Twisty. The one with mask. Which I don't even know what, how. I'm actually surprised that I was able to buy him, because there was only one pop of him left for like a month before I got him. Like, I guess he was so well hitting, I didn't hide it or anything. He was just like off to the corner behind another pop, and like no one ever looked there, so I got lucky and got him. Another one I just recently got like a month ago is another Game of Thrones. I guess you can say it's like a pop ride, even though she's flying the dragon like a boss, or mounting the dragon like a boss, either way. Try to get a good Again, this is not non. Haven't opened this yet. See the tape right there. I really want those sea dragons and the other one. I heard, I know there's a Hot Topic exclusive with him. I don't know why. I think it's just because he has red eyes. I don't think it's like metallic or anything, just the red eyes. Yeah. Next, the biggest pop I own, and the one I've just recently gotten. Invisible Jet. I can't even fit it in the frame. Or can I? Yeah, barely. She's actually the reason I started this video, because when I got her, or it, I thought I had something like 39 pops. Turns out I had like 45. I'm like, hold up. How many fucking pops do I have? Fuck it, I'm making a video. So yeah. The new DC lineup too. Well, not lineup, but the new pops we're gonna get with this line. I think the only new ones are these three, or these two. Cyborg's been out for a while, Firestorm too, along with Manta. Whew, okay then. Last couple of pops. We got Invisible Cheshire Cat, or Cheshire Cat. Now, okay, this is, I think, the first set. No, third set, son of a bitch. Series 3. Oh, okay. I don't keep up with these series, as you can obviously tell. Yeah. These two guys and Jessie. Where's Jessie? She's not on here. If you are a Toy Story collector or Funko Pop, those three are gonna kill you. Six if you count the Woody, Buzz, and like. There's like another variant of Woody. He's like dressed up in like a baseball uniform. Those others are gonna break your wallet. And then we got the Hot Topic exclusive Goku. Goku! Yes, I am a big DBZ fan. It's actually my first anime I ever watched. I've been watching it since I was like 4 or 5. Started at the Frieza Saga, or Namek Saga, whichever. I really want the Golden Frieza and Super Saiyan God Goku. And they're finally coming out with a Series 2 of Dragon Ball Z, so yeah, that should be tight. Next, we got Arkham Knight, aka Jason Todd, aka Red Hood. Surprisingly, you don't get another Joker pop. I like the game. Was it easy? For the most part, yeah. Once you finish it once, it's like fucking easy as shit. I really don't like how they handle Jason's backstory though. Spoiler. Cause like, they made him too much of a whiner. Like, in the comics, when he comes back, he does whine a bit, but he's mostly pissed off that Batman didn't kill Joker after actually killing him. Because Jason does die in the comics. It doesn't get faked out or anything. Next up, we got Vegeta. Prince of Saiyans. Like I said, again with the Game of Thrones, you can model your pops. Obviously, Prince Vegeta, you're gonna put him right on that fucking throne. Hold up.
Boom.
I'm just gonna put a picture of them together, or him on the throne. Next up, a New York Comic Con exclusive Nightmare on Elm Street. Shit. You know what I mean. Jack Skellington with Vampire Teddy. I think that's one of the gifts he gave to their little kids. Yeah, Series 7. Holy shit, how many sets do they have? And up next is Pumpkin King Jack, Hot Topic exclusive. Again, Series 7. He's actually more like a holiday pop. By what I mean by that is, like, he'll come out every October. So if you don't get him 1 year, you know, I'm pretty sure you'll get him the next year. If not, you can just go to like another store and get and pick him up. Because, like, the only thing that makes him a Hot Topic exclusive is that he glows in the dark. Other than that, you can just get him in any other store. The same thing goes for the Day of the Dead Jack and the Day of the Dead Sally, along with Santa Claus Jack. I think he's a December exclusive, obviously, because the whole Christmas thing. On next, we got Gar Waffles! I'm sorry, I had to. It's Gurr. You know Gurr. If you don't, the fuck. Yeah, Gurr's fucking awesome. Let's see, get that text in. Focus. Ah, I swear these cameras. Alright, next to last. Woo. We got Moriarty with crown from the TV show Sherlock. They really need a season 4 already. Come on. Or season 3. I can't remember where I left off. It's been like 6 months to a year since I've seen Sherlock. But yeah. He's actually pretty heavy. And the detail on him is superb, especially on the crown. Alright. All but one pop left. And of course, I had to make it the first pop that I ever got. And it is Deadpool. He's the one that started all this out. Here, there's his lineup. Let's see, collect them all, no? He is what got me started into Funko Pops. I don't even know why I bought him. It wasn't even because of the movie. I think the movie was still like a year away, maybe, tops. Sorry. But yeah. I never imagined collecting all these pops and more, because I am gonna get more as soon as I get more space. But yeah. Fun. I'm a little upset because I started collecting pops like right before I saw some of the exclusive ones that like shot up in price. We'll get to that. I saw the bank robber Joker, which is like impossible to find in any website now, and the Hot Topic exclusive Goat Smaug, along with the, I think this is the most expensive pop that I could have bought but didn't, the invisible Bilbo Baggins from, I think it was the first Hobbit movie or the second. Like, I started collecting pops right after those went out. I'm like, fuck. I go back online, seeing the pops that I saw. Like, really? Fucking A. But, you know, it is what it is. It's, except for the fucking bank robber Joker. I want that one bad. But yeah, I actually fucked up right now. How? I don't know. It was like sitting right there in front of me. But yeah, the final pop that I have is, of course, the Dark Knight Joker. This guy is fucking awesome. Heath Ledger did an awesome, amazing job, and I'm hoping Jared Leto can do an even better, if not on par with Heath Ledger's Joker. And I cannot wait for the Killing Joke animated movie coming out this summer, so be on the lookout for that. Voiced by the original Batman from the 93 cartoon and Mark Hamill. So those two actors are coming back to voice Batman and Joker for the Killing Joke movie, which is going to be awesome. And it is going to be rated R, if you haven't yet heard. Ooh, but yeah, that is all my pops. Welcome back, guys. Sorry, my phone ran out of storage, so I had to delete a couple things by uploading the video up onto my computer, then deleting it off my phone. But yeah, that was my whole Funko Pop collection. I don't know when this video will be posted up, maybe by Monday, if not Tuesday, because I gotta take a lot of pictures and a lot of editing. So yeah, thank you guys for joining me. See you guys next time.